One of the biggest things you would be expected to do as a US GI was marching. They would march for miles, and because of this, they had to ensure that they had a place to store their food, toiletries, tentage, and other essential tools. This is where your haversack will come in. The M1928 haversack was the primary field pack issued to US troops during the war. While they were not the only model manufactured and issued to troops overseas, they were the most common, being issued from the start of the war all the way to the end.
These packs feature a rather interesting design. Being a modification of the World War I pack, the M1910, they feature a closing system through a series of flaps that keep your equipment tucked inside of it. A tail was an accessory that can be seen on these packs as well, often seen to hold in a bedroll. They feature a canvas pouch with a strap keeping it closed. Known as your meat can pouch, it holds your mess tin and utensils for eating. Underneath your meat can pouch is a tab with two grommets. This was used to hold issued shovels and other such entrenching tools to your pack. On the side of the main flap are two more grommets. These are to hold your bayonet. The pack consists of six straps that attach to the belt and the pack itself. The two main straps connect to two D-rings on the bottom, forming a backpack which helps to support your back when carrying the pack.
The remaining straps attach to your cartridge belt, with the two lower straps attaching to the back and the two upper ones connecting towards the front.
In terms of where you can buy these packs, at the front, World War II Impressions and Well Priced Glory all make good reproductions of these packs. You can also find them very readily available on places like eBay. Today, the primary focus of this video is to educate on how to pack these. Not only how the Army would pack them, but also how you can pack them as a new reenactor. There were three particular ways that they would pack the haversack: heavy, medium, and light. These were for a number of different scenarios, depending on what environment you were in.
Heavy packing your haversack would be intended for when you were marching. Your pack was filled to the brim with equipment, such as food, extra clothing, and toiletries, all of which would go into the pack itself. Raincoats or field jackets can be tied down via the closing flap on your pack. In addition, you would use your tentage to roll your blankets, poles, and other things into a horseshoe pack. This wraps over top of the haversack and uses your tent rope to retain it against the pack. If depicting a marching pack, it is important to make it as overpacked as possible, so fill it to the absolute limit.
Moderately packing your haversack is one of the more common ways you will probably be packing it. When in a combat zone, a soldier would store what they would need to survive 24 to 48 hours. This could consist of something to wear for chilly nights, toiletries, extra socks, as well as K-rations. It was also encouraged to keep your raincoat with you in that closing flap, being a convenient spot to keep it, although the back of your cartridge belt could prove to be more secure. Lightly packing your haversack is the final variation. This would be primarily for patrols to lighten your load to make you more maneuverable. You typically would put the absolute minimum in. Socks and some K-rations would really be all you needed. However, keep in mind that it was fairly common CGIs just ditch the haversack altogether and would just opt for their cartridge belt and a bandolier. Now, as a new reenactor, chances are you don't have a lot of these finer detail items. So, as a good placeholder, some issued Army blankets are really all that you would need to give your haversack a filled appearance. You can find blankets at gun shows, surplus stores, and eBay for pretty affordable prices.
Whether they be trudging through the jungles of the Pacific or the hedgerows of France, soldiers depended on this vital piece of equipment to carry their personal belongings, rations, and mess equipment. No matter how cumbersome they were an absolute necessity to our fighting men, as they are to the basic equipment of your impression. With all that being said, we hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to stay tuned for future episodes.
And remember,
you're in the Army now, you're not behind the plow. You'll never get rich by digging a ditch, you're in the Army now. You're in the Army now, you're in the Army now. You'll never get rich on the salary which you get in the Army now.